So now we're leaving Poland, and today we have been driving a lot, and the road was closed. It was an accident or something like that at some point, so we thought we were going to be late for the ferry. And, we saw some beautiful scenery on the way from Warsaw to Gdansk, but I don't really know. It's beautiful, but I don't really, there's something with Poland that I don't really like. It might be me as well, and it's we always have to go back to ourselves and see if it's our attitude or our minds that says that things are bad. Like, so many times I have gone to meetings at church, and I used to say that this meeting was not good, and it was not a good meeting. But I learned that first I need to go to myself and ask if there's something in me that made the meeting bad. Because even if it's bad, it doesn't have to be bad to somebody else. So we have to be careful about what we say in that case. And as you can see, the Polish people, they drive like maniacs, and so many really close situations on the road today. It was actually crazy. So I'm glad we made it to the harbor in time, because we were in a line there in the middle of the forest somewhere, because we had to take a forest road when the main road was closed. And we could have avoided all that if I had taken another route from the beginning, but we're here, we left the country, and it's funny to see how this tour came together, and now these 3 days we're gonna travel again. I'm gonna go over a little bit the highlights from this tour, and we started in Poland, we ended in Poland, and Warsaw was a big thing for Brother Michael, and that was on his heart to visit the gas chambers and this. So it was horrible, but good for him to see it. And I praise God that we had Michael Byerlin with us. And here you see how we met at the hotel parking lot. Marcus picked us up, and we were gonna go somewhere, but we met these people, and we started to talk. And
her too.
She's from Africa.
He does video vlogs.
Talking about Africa, and I don't know why did you two start to talk. You looked at his car.
My license plate.
Your license plate. And these are a brother and a sister. So now we met another brother and another sister, and we're gonna be in heaven together.
Amen.
And we're gonna be in your city on May the 5th.
5th, yeah. And I hope you come to me. Yeah, visit me, and we have to talk and drink coffee and have a good time. And then we have to think when you're coming again, please.
You can come with this many people, make an evangelism.
Yeah.
This is how God works.
Okay, that's divine connection.
Yeah.
So this is how God works.
Truly.
We just have to follow the Holy Spirit, and God's timing is the right timing. So it was so nice to meet you.
Yeah,
amen.
Surely.
Thank amen. You very much. Amen. We only can praise God for this.
Amen. So we met at that parking lot, and now we're good friends. We stay in touch. He came to Auschwitz to be there for Michael, as you see now.
I don't know what to expect when I go there, you know? Because I wanted to go there for quite a long time and just, I don't know, just make peace.
You know? But then when we were on that fourth building there or whatever, I just had a breakdown. And I mentally couldn't take it no more. And after I had the breakdown there, I thought that, okay, I'm ready to go to the next building. And then when we got downstairs and I seen all the other stuff and that, and then we got outside, and when I sat in a wheelchair for a minute to take a rest, I just really felt on my heart that God was like, you're done, you know? So it's okay, you don't have to go any further. And I just couldn't. I felt so numb inside. I just, so ashamed of myself, you know. And people think that, you know, that my racism came from crews and that I was involved with gangs and stuff. It didn't come from that. I was hurt many, many years ago. I don't want to share on camera here, but I explained to you last night, I told you how somebody had hurt me many years ago, and that's what made me have some hate. But that hate grew, and when I became involved with people who had that same ideology, then my hate grew, you know? And today, just, I feel so ashamed, you know? And I have a friend, my little buddy Jacob, and back in Canada, and he's a Polish guy. You know, he's joking around, he's a really good kid. And Jacob, if you're watching this, I want you to know something, buddy. I'm so sorry what your people went through, I'm telling you. Yeah, I'm so sorry to see what your people went through. And please tell your dad, I want to go back right now and just apologize to every Polish person and every Jewish person I've ever met, you know? And just want to go hug every black person I've ever hated, and, you know, every Arab, every everything I've ever insulted or cursed on, or anybody that wore a turban on their head that I yelled at or cursed on. Like, I can't believe I hated, but I believed in this stuff.
Michael also organized our last meeting in German in this trip, but we're gonna come to that later on, because that's one of the highlights, and this will be the end of this series of three programs of highlights. So, as you saw, Auschwitz was anything else than a lovely place. Auschwitz, we drove through Czech Republic, and we had the first meeting in Salzburg. I know Michael really loved it there, and he loved the people there. I had a toothache that night, so to me that was not a highlight. But next highlight was when we met in Nuremberg. We stayed one night in Nuremberg, and we met with some of the ambassadors, and we had a great time of fellowship there.
I am free. Like a bird in the sky, I am free, I am free.
then we drove a long way to Finland, and we had our first meeting, and we had two meetings the first Sunday, and then next Wednesday was something special was taking place at the meeting, because that was when my pastor Mats washed Michael's feet. So that was a very, very touching and special moment.
Because I spoke about theologians and how theologians bash me all the time because of my lack of education in that. And Pastor Mutz, did I say it right?
Mm-hmm.
Is an educated man. He's a theologian. And out of respect, he washed my feet. And that was... I don't want to get emotional or anything, but yeah. That was really, really nice. It meant a lot. And he told me, he said, the next time a theologian bashes me, to remember this day when a theologian washed my feet as a servant. And that made me feel like a king.
Rest of the week, Jyväskylä was good. And Tammisaari and Porvo, they all were good meetings. People listened and people got touched by God. And another highlight for me was when we went fishing during a couple of our days off in Finland.
Remember